In this video, I'm going to talk about the V taper and how to get it. One of the first goals of many bodybuilders is to build that V taper. You know, broad shoulders, wide flaring lats, little waist. One thing that most people do not realize about the V taper is it's all about proportions. When you make your waist smaller, it makes your shoulders and lats look much more muscular and wide by comparison. So if you have narrow hips, you have a huge advantage in making your V taper look more impressive. If you have wide hips like I do, you have a little more work cut out for you to develop your V taper. There's two ways to get the V taper: the fast and easy way and the slow and hard way. We all like quick and easy, so let's cover that first. The human body has a natural V taper, but when you're overweight, it causes a pear shape where your waist bulges out and goes up to narrow shoulders. The absolute fastest way to get a V taper is to lose weight. Drop your body fat down to 6 or 8%, get a narrow waist, and then very quickly you have a V taper and it makes your shoulders and lats look much more muscular and broad. There's a link in the description of this video to help you lose weight. Okay, let's say you're really skinny already, 6 or 8% body fat, or you have really wide hips like me. Well, then you have no choice but to get your V taper the hard and slow way, and that's by adding muscle. Adding muscle is much slower than losing fat, by a factor of 10. It can take a year or two before you have any visible change in your V taper by adding muscle. Now, there's two separate muscle groups you need to work to build your V taper. Let's talk about if you want to build your V taper with a shirt on first. If you want to look good with a shirt on, what you need to do is make your shoulders broader, because when you have broad shoulders, even with a baggy shirt, it makes your V taper look much more impressive. To do a shoulder widening, you need to do a complete shoulder workout. There's no one exercise you can do. So please click on the link in the description of this video for a complete shoulder workout. Now, on the other hand, if you want a V taper with your shirt off, like I always have, you need to do shoulders and lats. Your lats are right here and give you a V taper from the back with your shirt off. To do your lats, the number one exercise is pull-ups. If you've never done pull-ups before, there's a link in the description of this video you can click on to get started. So there you have it. To get a V taper, you gotta do three things. Number one, you gotta drop your body fat down to 6 or 8% to get a really narrow, small waist to make your shoulders and lats look much wider by comparison. Second thing, you gotta build your shoulders wider. Again, this is a really slow process compared to losing the body fat. And number three, you gotta build your lats. So that's it for today, how to get a V taper. Auf Wiedersehen.